In this video, we are going to plan a day's menu for a software executive female aged 30 years. Software executive female is a sedentary worker. So what we have to do is, we have to refer to the RDA for a sedentary woman. This is the first step in the process of planning a day's menu. We have three important steps, and the first step is referring to the RDA for a sedentary woman. In the RDA table, from the RDA table, I have taken the energy, protein, carbohydrate, and fat for a sedentary woman. Energy requirement is about 1900 kilocalorie per day. Protein is 50 gram per day. Carbohydrate is 380 gram per day. And fat is 20 gram per day. So these are the recommended dietary allowances for a sedentary woman, and these requirements are based on ICMR NIN 2010. And the second step consists of the food list, that is deciding the portion size and from the basic food groups. So the food list consists of the basic food groups in the column and the necessary portions for a sedentary or a moderate or a heavy working man or a woman. So in the column, we are able to see the cereals and millets, and in the rows, you can find the portion size, that is 30 gram. One portion is equal to 30 grams, and for a sedentary woman, we have to give or allot 9 portions of cereals and millets. Similarly, we have to provide her with 2 portions of cereals, and each portion they measure 30 grams. For milk and milk products, we have 3 portions. So one portion is 100 ml for milk. So we are giving 300 ml of milk for a sedentary woman. Then for vegetables, roots and tubers, green leafy vegetables, other vegetables, we have to provide them with 2 portions, green leafy vegetable 1 portion, other vegetables 2 portions, fruits 1 portion, sugar we have to give them 4 portion, one portion is 5 grams. Similarly, fat also we have to provide them with 4 portions, and one portion weighs 5 grams. Okay, so this is the first step. This is known as food list, which is designed by ICMR. Otherwise, we can call it as food exchangist or a ready reckoner. Usually in hospitals, we follow this ready reckoner to calculate the nutrient value of the diets. Like when you go to your dietitian and when you are telling about the daily food intake, they'll be calculating mentally your nutrient intake by using this food ready reckoner. Okay, so this ready reckoner is used as an instant calculation tool. Okay, so this is the food list and the portions required for the sedentary worker. Now coming to the portion size of raw foods and nutrients. Here we have the basic food groups like cereals and millets, and here we have the portion size, like one portion, that is 30 grams of cereals and millets, they provide 100 grams of energy, 3 grams of protein, 20 grams of carbohydrate, and 0.8 grams of fat. For example, we saw in the food list or exchange list that a sedentary woman should be provided with 9 portions of cereals. So what we should do here, we have to multiply 9 into 100. So from cereal and millets, the energy will be provided will be 900 kilocalories. Similarly, protein, 9 into 3, 27. So the cereals and millets, they provide about 27 grams of proteins. Similarly, you can calculate for carbohydrate, fat, and so on. And in the sedentary women food list, we saw that 2 portions were provided for pulses, were allotted for pulses. So 2 portion is 60 gram. So what we have to multiply this 100 into 2. So the amount of energy provided by pulses is 200, because we are giving 2 portions. Similarly, from protein, we are getting 12 grams of protein, and from carbohydrate, 2 into 15, 30. So we have to calculate the portion size into the nutrient value to calculate the nutrient intake of the person. Okay. So these 3 steps are very important in calculating the nutritive value. The first step is the recommended dietary allowances. You have to buy out these recommended dietary allowances. While calculating in the class for your observation, you can refer to your recommended dietary allowances. But during examination, you won't be provided with recommended dietary allowance sheets. So you have to buy out this, and it should be in the tip. Similarly, portion size also, you have to buy out for sedentary, moderate, heavy, man and woman, and for kids, for everybody. You have to be thorough with the portion size. And the same way, this the energy, protein, carbohydrate, and fat requirements, as well as the energy provided by cereals, millets, pulses, all these tables you have to buy out and be thorough with these 3 tables. These first 3 steps are important in calculating the nutrient requirements for a menu. Let us go to the next step, 4th step. So this is a sample menu plan for an adult woman sedentary given by ICMR. Okay, so you can just go through this. What they have given is breakfast, they have given milk and cereal pulses. Then lunch, they have given cereal pulses, vegetable, 2 vegetables. And then for tea, they have given milk, cereal. Then for dinner, again cereal pulses, vegetables, milk. Again, one more vegetable and then fruit. This is the menu they have planned for a sedentary woman. So keeping this as a guide, we can plan a menu for a sedentary woman. Okay, this is our menu planning. So now, see, I have divided the diet sheet into 5 columns. For one for mealtime, others for food group. Then the raw portion size, cooked recipe, and then the serving amount. So mealtime, I have given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 frequent meals. You can give even 7, or you can give 5 as you wish. But it is better to keep the frequencies between 5 to 7. Okay. Then for early morning, I have given coffee. Coffee contains milk and sugar. 100 ml of milk is provided, and then the 10 grams of sugar. Here I have given 1 cup of coffee. Usually 1 cup measures 200 ml. Universal measurement, 1 cup is 200 ml. So we can dilute 100 ml into 200 ml and make a coffee of 200 ml. Okay. Then coming to break. Usually we don't calculate nutritive value for coffee, tea, any health drink like that. Okay, we calculate only for milk and sugar. Then for breakfast, I am giving ben pongal with brinjal kustu. So the ingredients I have added are 50 grams of cereals and 20 grams of pulses. And for vegetable kustu, I have added 50 grams of brinjal, tomato, green leafy vegetables. So these are the raw ingredients I have added. And this is the menu for the breakfast. So ben pongal is 1 cup. And kustu is 1 small katori. I have also added from green leafy vegetable, curry leaf of 10 grams. Then coming to lunch. Cereal is 100 grams. That is rice, 1 bowl. Pulses is for sambar. I have given chow chow sambar. So I have added 20 grams of pulses for sambar and chow chow 50 grams. Then for vegetable, lady's finger, poriyal, 100 grams of lady's finger has been added. Then for milk exchange, I have given 100 ml of curd, and then curry leaf for seasoning, sambar and poriyal, as well as curve. So this is the lunch plan, menu planning for lunch. Then coming to tea time. Tea time, I have given vegetable sandwich, that is two slices of bread with cucumber, carrot, coriander. Okay, this two sandwiches, they weigh about 50 grams, and the vegetables, they weigh 50 grams. Green leaf vegetable, coriander, 50 grams. Then for tea, I have taken 50 ml of milk, sugar 10 grams. Along with that, I have given a fruit also, that is 100 grams of watermelon, because I have given the seasonally available fruits, so I have added watermelon. Then for dinner, coming to the dinner, I have given 90 grams of cereals, that is 3 chapatis. 1 chapati is 30 grams, so I have given 3 chapatis. And veg curry. This veg curry contains dal, onion, carrot, cauliflower, tomato, capsicum, French beans. And they all weigh about, these vegetables, they are about 150 grams, and the green leafy vegetable is about 30 grams. It is nothing but coriander and curry leaf. Even you can add mint leaf. Okay. Then for bedtime, I have given milk 50 ml. You can even dilute it to 200 ml. Then sugar 10 grams. Fruit is 100 gram. Banana, which is available, is commonly available fruit. And I have given a medium-sized banana for bedtime. Usually, what a scientist say that banana and milk, when they are taken together, it helps in the increase of tryptophan level, and amino acid that helps in sleeping, that calms our mind and helps and makes us to sleep peacefully. So I have given milk and banana in combination. Okay, so this step is over. This is the fourth step and this is over. Now coming to the fifth step. What I have done, I have lifted the cereal food group list along with portion size and their nutrients. I have lifted it and I have put it here for your reference, so that it will be easy for you to convert the cereals and millets. So what we have to do first, we have to count the total portion of cereals, pulses, milk and milk products. Everything we have to count down and put it here. Like for example, the portion size for cereals and millet is 9.2. How come it comes to 9.2? So here we have 50 gram, again 100 gram, 50 gram, 200 gram. Then again cereal, 90 gram. So 290. Actually, when you divide 290 by 30, we get 9.2. The answer is 9.2. Okay. That is 290 when divided by 3, we get 9.2 portion size. So we have 9.2. You go to cereal and then multiply the 9.2 with energy, you get 920. Then same 9.2 into 3, 9.2 into 20, 9.2 into 0.8. This is 7.36. Next one is pulse. We provided two portions of pulses. So pulse, one portion provides 100 calories. So what happens here? It is 200. Then protein, it provides 6 grams of protein. So it is 12. Then one portion provides 15 grams of carbohydrate. So I have given here 30. And 0.7 fat, so it is 1.4. So similarly, we have to calculate for milk and milk product, fruits and tubers, green leafy vegetables, other vegetables, fruit, sugar, fats and oil. Okay. Since we didn't cook egg, meat, chicken and fish, I didn't include it in this table. And if you want to add egg, meat, chicken or fish, you can replace it with pulses. For example, you are giving two exchange of pulses. You can change it to one exchange of pulse, one portion of pulse, and one portion of egg or one portion of chicken or fish, anything. Or even you can substitute the whole pulse exchange with meat exchange or chicken exchange. Instead of giving pulses, you can give two exchange of chicken or two exchange of fish or two exchange of egg. It is up to you. If the patient is a non-vegetarian, you can change the replace pulse for non-vegetarian items. So after calculating all these values, now we have to find the total. So the total value of calorie from the above diet is 1,629. Protein is 55.2. Carbohydrate is 277 and fat is 20.7. In our RDA, we had only 1,900 kilocalories, 50 grams of protein, and 20 grams of fat. So this value is more or less okay. Roughly, this is okay. So you can put a tick for this one. Whereas we have to increase the calorie value, and as well as we have to decrease the protein value to 50. It can come around 52 or 53. And similarly, the calorie value can come like 1,800 to 2,000. It can come. Okay. So in this diet, we have to improve the total calorie intake by making up to 1,900. And the protein content, you have to reduce it to 50 by making changes here. Like protein, cereals and millets provide 27.6. What we can do is cut off one or two portions. Like you can provide 7 portions of cereals, and then you can add fruits and tubers or other vegetables. You can increase the amount so that they will provide carbohydrate without increasing the protein. Similarly, protein you can decrease, and the energy value will be increased. You can also add honey dippings for fruits. Then you can prepare sago payasam, like foods that are rich in carbohydrate alone. If you add, the calorie value can increase. At the same time, protein value will not increase. Okay, hope you are clear with this one. And so for a menu planning, for a proper menu planning, you should be thorough with the first three steps. That is RDA, recommended dietary allowances prescribed by ICMR. Then the portion size, that is also prescribed by the ICMR. And the third one, raw foods, nutrient values. All these three, you should be thorough, and you can easily calculate the nutrient value of the given menu. Okay.